Ghosting? What is that? Talking about ghosting with me, Dea. Saat ini kita akan membahas tentang ghosting, tapi how that's talk not talk about black and white. Tapi di sini bukan berarti hitam dan putih yang melayang-layang, but it's talk about love. Kita membahas tentang cinta yang ada di ghosting. Lalu, what does it means of ghosting itself? Apa sih arti dari ghosting ketika kita berada dalam cinta? Sometimes we feel that it's scary, yes of course. Hal yang menakutkan. Seperti biasanya hantu yang melayang pergi tanpa saying anything. That's right. Ghosting, it's mean that when you meet with someone, ketika teman-teman bertemu dengan seseorang, you make a date, you have talking each other, chatting each other, but finally, one of the couples is left. Ditinggalkan. Entah ditinggalkannya without any say sorry, without say goodbye and anything, tiba-tiba pergi aja melayang tanpa ada kabar dan sebagainya. Nah, that's called by ghosting into our dating. So, kalau teman-teman tiba-tiba udah deket, nyaman dan sebagainya, tiba-tiba ditinggalin tanpa adanya kabar, that's right, called by ghosting. You ghosting by someone. So, really take care about your dating itself. Next, hal yang perlu kita perhatikan yaitu how we move on from our ghosting. Bagaimana kita berpindah atau you know you say that there are a lot of actress that they also do as a move on. Mereka juga melakukan move on. Move, it doesn't mean that you need to be moved to someone else, someone new, and it's not talking about that ones. Jadi berpindah di sini bukan berarti teman-teman berpindah pasangan. Nanti berpindah pasangan tapi hatinya tetap menempel di sana. Janganlah ya. So move on, it's mean berjalan terus. So do all everything that you want to do. Lakukan semuanya yang pengen teman-teman lakukan. So the first, maybe you able to have songs or we know that the word I lost you but I found me. Saya kehilangan kamu, tapi saya menemukan diri saya sendiri. As like another actress or our singer says, gak apa-apa kok kita kehilangan seseorang, tapi kita menemukan diri kita sendiri. Self-love, it's really worth it. Jadi self-love itu sangat berharga bagi kita. So, verse, how do you move on? We can say that how we listen to the songs. Mari kita dengarkan song-song yang ada. It's like, you know the first song of New Rules? Nah, di situ ada beberapa songs dari New Rules. So, let's check it out. We will listen to the songs. Mari kita dengarkan lagunya dari Dua Lipa yang berjudul New Rules, Peraturan. variables that we have into the songs yang dimiliki Dua Lipa tadi, yaitu new rules. Yang pertama, we have don't pick up his phones, jangan angkat teleponnya. Second, don't let him in, jangan biarkan dia masuk ke dunia kita. Third, don't be his friend, jangan menjadi temannya. So what does it means of he? Apa sih maksud yang ada di situ? So he said that he's calling you when he's drunk and alone. Seperti dia bisa jadi nelpon teman-teman ketika they're feeling bored or feeling down. He is drunk, lagi minum, lagi mabuk, ya kan? And he is feeling alone. Dia merasa sendiri. Barulah di situ dia akan telepon teman-teman. So don't let him in into yourself. Jangan biarkan dia masuk. First itu jangan angkat teleponnya dia, apalagi ketika dia lagi sendiri dan dia lagi mabuk. So please don't pick up his phone. Jangan angkat teleponnya. And second, don't let him in. You have to keep kick him out. Teman-teman harus menendangnya keluar dari kehidupan teman-teman. Jadi yang kedua, don't let him in. Jangan biarkan dia masuk ke dunia teman-teman lagi dan lagi. Stop it. You need to kick. You need to have your vision and missions for getting yourself to be better. Untuk mendapatkan diri teman-teman yang lebih bagus dan lebih baik dari sebelumnya. And the third, we have, you know, you're gonna wake up in his bed in the morning. Jadi jangan sampai teman-teman you will be accept him again and finally you see him in the early morning. Teman-teman melihat dia di pagi hari. So please you don't need to be his friend anymore. Teman-teman tidak perlu lagi menjadi temannya. You don't need to be a friend if is it unnecessary. Kalau itu memang tidak dibutuhkan. So please kick him out, keluarkan dia ke dalam hidup teman-teman, di dalam hidup teman-teman. So kick him. And the next things that we need to do, dan hal lain yang bisa kita lakukan, do more activities, even that's going to be sport, how to make you strong. Sport mungkin bikin membuat teman-teman lebih kuat, or you may be more healthy, atau mungkin akan lebih sehat. Nah, jadi whatever the sport that you like, even that's going to be yoga or football or even some or martial art atau pencaksilat dan sebagainya. Whatever the sport that you like, or going to the gyms atau mungkin pergi ke gym, bahkan you look better into your body and it's more healthy, atau membuat tubuh biar lebih membentuk, lebih bagus dan lebih sehat, bisa ke gym. Or even you can follow some of organizations. Boleh juga ikutin beberapa organisasi yang ada. Whatever the organization that you like, apapun organisasi yang teman-teman suka, even into your university, mungkin di kuliah teman-teman, or even into your jobs, into your work, ketika berada pada dunia kerja, whatever the workshop, events, mungkin workshop atau seminar yang ada, that it can be improve yourself to be better, mungkin untuk lebih baiknya. So whatever is that, do more activities that you can do into positive ways. And the next step that we need to do, dan step lainnya yang bisa kita lakukan, maybe it's unexpected, any hal yang tidak terduga. Maybe you feel bored because no one are better to have communication with you. Mungkin teman-teman merasa bosan karena didekatin orang, atau merasa apa, berkomunikasi dengan teman-teman lama yang ditanyain tentang apa, our dating with our spouse or others, mungkin hal-hal yang lainnya. Maybe you can get any new dating applications, mungkin dengan dating application. Karena kalau dating application, siapa tahu kita menemukan seseorang yang baru, sosok yang baru di dunia kita, that he will not asking about our past and we go through for our future. Kita lanjut aja untuk menuju ke masa depan, ya kan? Jadi ada beberapa that it make you feeling good, mungkin feeling good like I could or like I should. Jadi mungkin teman-teman akan merasakan feeling yang lebih bagus lagi dan lebih ready untuk bertemu dengan orang-orang baru. Kalau orang-orang lama biasanya kan maybe you feel toxic with your boundaries, mungkin merasa nggak enak sama teman-teman yang lama ditanyainnya itu-itu mulu. Jadi bisa banget nih ke dating application untuk nemuin teman-teman baru. Maybe it can be Tantans or Tinder, or whatever is that. You can find a lot of dating application into your Play Store. So teman-teman bisa banget temuin dating application di situ. But remember, you need to get ready to face your your new dating untuk teman dating yang baru. And don't forget to to love yourself before you got your dating. Sebelum menemukan dating apps-nya dulu, sembuhkan dulu luka hatinya. Siapa tahu juga dia bisa menyembuhkan lebih untuk diri teman-teman. But you need to get self-love. Teman-teman harus banget mencintai diri teman-teman sebelum masuk ke dating app applications. Dating applications. Well, that's all. And udah. And the last thing that we need to do, because for you are the person who ready to make a commitments, untuk teman-teman yang mungkin sudah siap banget untuk berada pada commitment with someone else, so better for you to preparing yourself before going to have the new dating that you have communicate with. Untuk komunikasi dengan siapapun itu nantinya, better for you to prepare yourself untuk menyiapkan diri teman-teman. Events, walaupun itu tadi dari aktivitas-aktivitas yang sudah disiapkan, dari application yang sudah disiapkan, teman-teman mungkin lebih memilih untuk menyiapkan dirinya for being a good mother to be, a good father to be, untuk menjadi calon ibu dan calon ayah. Wow, it's look like really closer. Dekat banget ya untuk bahas pernikahan, but it's not about that, but how you communicate with. Bagaimana teman-teman memiliki komunikasi yang bagus, and how do you collaborate with your partner. Bagaimana teman-teman berkolaborasi dengan partnernya untuk preparing yourself to be better. Banyak sekali sih ya, kalau kita lihat into influencer that talk about premarital marriage is like, sebelum status menikah kita harus menyiapkan as like pre yoga biar tubuhnya sehat terlebih dahulu, atau mungkin menyiapkan mental karena sekarang banyaknya it's talk about mental illness, mental disorder. Nah, akhirnya lebih baik menyiapkan mental biar berkomunikasinya lebih bagus dan sebagainya. So get ready for that. Being a person into commitments is hard, but it's nice to try to communicate and commitment with someone that we really love it. So well, thank you. So in conclusions, di dalam kesimpulannya, hal-hal untuk kita avoid to get ghosting, atau ya walaupun udah terlanjur di ghosting sama seseorang, but the things that you need to know that you are better to get someone that is ready to get you better. Untuk jadi jangan khawatir buat teman-teman that you ghost by someone else. Mungkin teman-teman akan mendapatkan seseorang yang lebih baik. And remember to get self-love into yourself. Cintai diri teman-teman terlebih dahulu. You better to know and to get yourself deeply. Jadi untuk lebih tahu diri teman-teman lebih dalam, it's mean that you need to ready to face everything about your partner. Jadi harus siap menemukan partner yang seperti apapun itu nanti dengan mencintai diri kita terlebih dahulu. Dari kita mencintai diri seseorang, so we will be easily to love someone. Kita akan lebih mudah untuk mencintai seseorang. Jangan sampai kita mencintai seseorang terlebih dahulu, namun mencintai kita di diri kita di akhir, gitu kan? And if you want to get deeply with the humans, you need to get deeply to the God itself. Jadi temuin Tuhannya, atau mungkin tikung dia di sepertiga malam. Wow. Atau apa ya? Ya whatever that you do, apapun yang teman-teman lakukan, that is how you get better. Bagaimana untuk diri teman-teman lebih bagus dari sebelumnya. Jangan hanya membaguskan diri atau memperbaiki diri karena seseorang, tapi perbaiki itu karena diri teman-teman. Well, thank you. And that's what I can say. Everything that you can do into move on and then listen to the songs or do more activities and then dating applications and also preparing yourself into workshop or premarital status. Nah, teman-teman bisa gunakan itu untuk step-step bagaimana teman-teman move on or getting better from the ghosting itself. Well, thank you for watching. I hope that it's going to be clear enough for you who got sad because of ghosting. Yang sedih karena ghosting, semoga aja membantu untuk teman-teman lebih relax, chillax. Bukan chillock, tapi chillax, chill and relax to do and to face everything about your partner. Dan don't forget for like, subscribe, and also comments into the below. Jadi biar lebih bagusnya lagi video apa yang pengen teman-teman butuhkan. So that are the things that we know. Ghosting is not a kind of scary, bukan hal yang menakutkan, tapi ghosting adalah an actions that your partner will leave you without saying anything. Ya, walaupun menakutkan, tapi gak apa-apa. Masih banyak wanita atau laki-laki di luar sana. Well, thank you.